up, I said, I think something special's happening tonight. So welcome everybody to our show. I hope you're as good as last night's audience. They laughed at all the jokes, which the children appreciate and the scriptwriter also appreciates. So thank you for that. You didn't really come in here to hear and speak to me. So I just say, to honour the children who put so much into it, if you do get a bit of the coughs, please take them out the back. And if you have a child that has that as well. And I don't know if you noticed, we are filming it, so please turn these ones off. That's it for me. Enjoy the show, and I'll see you at the end.
Good morning and welcome back to the annual Quiz, kids, quiz. The tension is really building. After months of Australian-wide competition, only three teams remain. Firstly, the reigning champions, Entitlement Ladies College. Representing Entitlement, Amanda Bridget and Jane Smith. But this year, the girls from Entitlement will get a real one for their money from the second qualifying finalists, Crucifixion College! It's been 34 years since Crucifixion was last brought to the cup. But in the meantime, they've made it to nine finals in a row. Word from the Crucifixion camp is they're fielding their best team yet. The team of Tom, Turbo, Tudman, and Condi, the guard Corleone. This year's third. Harmony Heights High have never competed in the quiz before, much as made it to the finals. The team of Neil Egan and Phoebe Rainbow are sailing into uncharted waters.
Ow. Inside sources say there's still rumblings over at Harmony whether their school should be competing at all. Harmony's school philosophy has always been strictly no competing. Their school doesn't believe in competition of any kind, sporting, academics, or otherwise.
What about the tree hugging competition?
Small carbon footprint barefoot scroll races. Surely you can be better at being green. Fuck!
All the greenies I know think they're better at everyone, at everything. They're the most competitive people I know.
Fuck! They can't just give you a coffee. It comes in a lecture. My dog gave it. Rainbow certified. Child labour free. And I picked the dog by dissing my dog big man. Fuck!
Jane, 90 girl, what's the matter? You must
job. Remarkably talented though I am.
We all know the quiz is poor Plain Jane's moment to shine.
A plain-looking scholarship girl is certainly not going to get by on her looks now, is she? It's not like she can fall back modelling as a career option, is it? Amanda, that will do.
You know we won't be winning anything tomorrow without Jane. Right, Jane, dear girl. Breathe nice and slowly. That's it.
Thank you. Yes, she's quite hilarious. Wait till you see our dance to be blown away.
Yup, you won't see nothing yet. Girls, check this out.
Joy and love. wrong. Very wrong. I don't want to play their stupid little game. It's just a capitalist plot designed to produce winners and losers.
Well, yes, that is the general idea of a competition.
Yes, but Phoebe, that's the whole point.
What point?
The point is, Phoebe, that competing is brutal and selfish and loathsome. It's about pushing someone down, crushing their spirit, so you're the winner and they're just like us, Phoebe. They're the losers.
Well, when you put it that way, but Neil, if the universe is telling us we should win, then we wouldn't be the losers, we'd be the winners.
But that's even worse. Then we'd be the brutal, selfish, and loathsome ones. There's no way out for us. We're doomed either way.
Neil, it'll be okay. Let's just check in and we can worry about the philosophy later.
Yes!
Bruce.
Your thoughts, Mr. Brady?
Well, if that's an indication of the level of the competition, it'll be one hell of a competition tomorrow. Great stuff, kids. Shazam!
What's up now, Mr. Brady?
Well, we now have a very special item, our welcome dance. And then, after some moving and grooving, it's off to bed for all of you. And teachers, don't forget, after the ball, it's bye to you two. Only quiz contestants can stay in the hotel tonight. But to important matters, it now gives me great pleasure to introduce our official quiz judge, Judge Stern.
Yeah.
No, it is a victory, the knowledge of small, yet important facts.
Any hints for this year? The questions?
Be careful.
Area of knowledge? History? Politics? Music? Spelling?
Who was that? She looks familiar. 2013 runner-up, back in the old day, and back at the quiz. Her team was up by 35 points. But, well, the golden question.
Oh. Poor kid.
See you tomorrow.
Thank you.
cross.
We're on in 5, 4, 3, 2.
Well, viewers, it's eerily quiet here at the hotel. All the contestants are tucked up in beds until tomorrow's sensational quiz.
Where the smartest kids in the country
battle it out. And what an action-packed start it's been.
The entitlement girls strutted their stuff early. And Harmony Heights were no slouches either.
But really packing a punch was crucifixion.
Judge Stern has set out the rules for this year's quiz and left no doubt about what's expected.
After hearing that speech, there'll be no cheating from this year's contestants.
And so, that's it from us, Buck and Chuck.
Signing off. Is that okay? Think I'll turn in. We've got an early start tomorrow.
Good idea, Miss. It's a big day.
But the very great here, boys and girls. Just remind all contestants that it's time for lights out. You should all now be in your rooms. Nighty night, sweet dreams. See you bright and early. Just out.
Thank you, Father, for seeing me with so little notice.
My little man, you sound distressed. How can I help?
Father, there's a quiz.
The 75th anniversary quiz. Is it tomorrow?
Yes, Father, and I'd really like to win it.
Well, Condoleezza, good luck. God be with you.
Thank Father, you. I'm not sure you understand. I really need to win it.
Why are you so
desperate to win it? Father, all of my family are big successes, and I want to show them that I'm as good as they are.
Condi, my dove, you are.
But Father, this is my chance. Right now, you see, there's a question, the golden question. And if I could find out the answer to the golden question...
Condoleezza, God works in mysterious ways.
But Father, the golden question...
Condoleezza, I'm not sure you understand. Address your prayer to Mother Mary if you must. But when you learn to accept God's will, its richness and beauty becomes apparent.
But Father, the golden question...
It is not our place to grasp God's purpose.
Yes, Father, thank you for your advice. Hail Mary, full of grace, our Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou. What's the use? That goody goody never had to win a quiz, just Shazam, Mother of God. I need some real help.
Where are you going?
Okay.
Where are you going?
Out.
You know you're not allowed to leave. You'll get us disqualified.
I need to see someone.
What?
Now? Yeah, bye.
Troubled. Most High Queen, I need to win the quiz.
My teacher, perhaps winning the quiz is not worth the disturbance to your soul.
Dear Queen, I fear my soul will never be at rest until I win.
My child, if you win with the aid of the Dark Powers, have you really won?
Your Majesty, my mum and dad won't know, nor my class, and I'll get the glory and fame and be happy.
And you are set upon this path.
Yes, Your Majesty.
A frog's leg, a drop of possum's milk, three snails, and a boogies of a seven-month-old female child. But still, I'm not fair.
Our frog's leg got the rest.
What are they all for?
To make a potion.
For what?
To drink. You want to win, don't you?
Me?
No, the other kids, so they win.
What does it taste like?
Like, delicious. The unadulterated taste of cheating. Go and get me a broccoli, and I'll be straight up to you in a flash.
Sure, I'll be back. Thanks, bye.
And she won't be back. Better at love than trivia.
I'm just bored. The whole thing is boring.
No, we're in the
Should have had that reason, Mr. Brady. Can't sleep now. You never know when someone will just...
The golden question and his answer. Now is my moment to seize the advantage to which I'm entitled. Now I can set things right, once and for all. It's only fair. But my girls will win without cheating. But the golden question is a cheat. It's not fair. Amanda really is a twit. And Jane will, you never know when she'll get rattled. It's not cheating, just justice for after all these years. I don't need to see it. We'll win anyway. I won't. What is the... It's not cheating. I already knew that. Jane knows that for sure. It didn't help us at all.
Ladies and gentlemen.
gentlemen, boys and girls, I'm Barry Brady, BB, and glad you could join us for the 75th National Whiz Kids Quiz. Ready for the big battle, kids?
Yes, yes Mr. Brady!
Yes, Mr. Brady.
Know the rules, kids?
Rules are for the weak!
Well, tell that to the judge.
To recap, it's 5 points per correct answer. 3 right in a row, 5 extra points. 3 wrong in a row, lose 5 points. The team with the most points wins.
We're ready, so let's play Shazam!
What's your first topic tonight, Mr. Brady?
We'll begin with music.
You heard Big BB. Music is up first.
All right, kids. Our first section is songs. You must name the song and the artist. College spelled kindness.
B-L-I-N-D-N-E-S.
not right. Tight is not always right.
K-I-N-D-N-E-S-S.
Great get, Phoebe. What is frustration?
A feeling of being unable to achieve something.
Right. What's an emotion?
A strong feeling.
And what's an emo?
Yes, ask Neil, what's an emo?
It's a derogatory term for disturbed teenagers.
Three in a row. Looks like Tight is right. Scores, Judge?
Entitlement, 50. Crucifixion, 20. And Harmony, 15. What a fast and furious start in Entitlement, with Jamie really on fire. The Crucifixion is snatching at the heels, and I wouldn't call Harmony up just yet.
Contestants are covered. Songs, local knowledge, maths, and psychology sections.
But they've still got politics and word skills left.
Your thoughts, Phoebe?
I'd say it's pretty close. Okay, viewers, let's go back to the quiz. Okay, quizzes, our next section is politics. You must... Who is the Prime Minister of Australia?
Bill Whitlam!
Wrong.
Anthony Albanese!
It won't be easy under Albanese!
Correct. Who won the 2020 US presidential election?
Donald Trump.
Wrong.
Joe Biden.
That's right, 5 points. Okay, who first said greed is good? Turbo.
The New South Wales Liberal Party.
No. Jay?
Clive Palmer?
No. Wrong. Amanda?
Kim Kardashian?
No. Neil?
Adam Barrett?
No. I said, who said this first?
Gordon Gekko in the 1980s classic film Wall Street is my all-time favourite. I've seen it 47 times.
Shazam! Great work. Do you know Mr. Gekko well?
No. But my Uncle Guido does.
Hey!
I protest! That question should have been in the entertainment part, not the politics part.
Hey, I can't tell the difference these days. Now, which country does not have a Bill of Rights?
Zimbabwe. The USA, man.
Victoria.
All wrong.
But if Victoria had a Bill of Rights, they'd have to have at least one Victorian on the Australian test team.
All wrong. Scores, Judge.
Entitlement, 55. Crucifixion, 30. And Harmony, 15.
Well, folks, that means we're to the final round.
Your thoughts, Mr. Brady?
Still very competitive and very exciting. Okay, kids, it's the last round where we'll really test your learned skills. Define the following word. University.
A centre of excellence and higher learning at a tertiary level.
95% of titles go there.
Great. Democracy.
The system of government by the whole population.
Even the stupid ones.
Usually through elected representatives.
Correct. Economics.
The study of wealth and its production.
Correct. Ecology.
The study of the relationship of living things in their environment.
Correct. Wow. Race.
The major divisions of humankind.
Correct. Egg and spoon race.
The study of a race of people with eggs.
Wrong.
You mucked it up. Egg and spoon race, like the little kids do at sports day.
A silly competition for ridiculous parents.
Correct. Cerebellum.
The center of excellence within the head of each entitlement.
She's wrong.
She's got the yips. Yip, yip, yip. We've got her.
Her friend Amanda's a member of the Yip and Spoon Race.
Sarah Miller, if you think about it calmly, it's all in the mind, Jane.
Judge?
Bay. But correct. No, I was talking to Jane.
No one ever really understands us.
Don't knock it. You're on the scoreboard. Emperor.
The Emperor Butterfly was first discovered by Wolfie One Wolf in 1832!
Wrong.
Yip, yip, yip. Emperor, ruler of an empire.
Well, easy to see where you're going. Next word, slave.
Something an Eskimo uses, which is degrading to dogs.
Wrong. Sandy?
Sledge. A legitimate way to gain a psychological advantage.
Legitimate. Correct. Incorrect.
A sledge is a mean way of upsetting someone during a game.
You really are on the board. Define bogan.
A person lacking class.
Correct. Example?
Nick Kyrgios.
And in a sentence?
Nick
is a cashed up bogan whose bands are all losers with big fluffy dice.
Correct.
No!
Now you understand the meaning of the word sledge.
Ooh. Hey, hey, hey! Now let's check the scores.
Entitlement, 75. Crucifixion, 35. And harmony, 30.
A final round up for you viewers. And to recap, entitlement on 75, crucifixion on 35, and harmony on 30.
But it's getting really tense now,
because coming up next, it's the big one, Golden Question.
Oh, whose hands in the balance?
Anyone could still win!
So now, the Golden Question, Judge. What is the national bird of Bosnia?
The European traitor bird! Safety from fear, safety from danger, and safety
didn't cheat. We want to be in a good game, not a bad one. The game's the most important thing. It's about being a part of it. And there's no game if the opposition is ruled out altogether.
What a bunch of cliches! You only like that girl because she found your fluffy dice.
It's a majority. I beg you, Judge, one chance.
What an unbelievable turn of events!
Turn of events unfolding here for you, viewers. The cheats have been let off the hook. The common question was just a fake. Martin to lay down the cheat. What now, Judge Stern?
The quizmaster, Barry Brady, will now ask the real golden question.
Okay. Now for the real golden question. What is the national bird of Australia?
Amanda. But Jane, thanks for getting us here and for putting up with me.
Never. My failure is complete. I'm done with smiling.
Come on, Condi, cheer up.
Come on, Condi.
Hey, Condi, do you like mutus?
We'll smash you all next time.
Magnificent. Join me for a milkshake.
Me? Sure.
Great.
Come on, everyone.
What's the national bird of Bosnia?
A trumped up Corella.
Shazam!
Responsibility for the show. They were so good at so many different things, at stepping in rehearsal with all the different changes at Fitzroy Community School. You ever notice there were lots of changes? With all of those changes, we had so many swaps and they all jumped in. So their teamwork was amazing, but the thing that I actually reflected on most was their courage. And my mother, Faye, says that the key of a great writer is to be brave, because you've got to put yourself out there. And boy, did they put themselves out there. Let's give them another clap. So really, really a huge thank you to the parents of all of these beautiful children, but especially the ones who led the show today. But a show doesn't work unless a lot of people put in. And we had backstage, we had Helen and we had two of our past students tonight, Anelsa and Romany. Come forward, the three of you, please. It's nice to have you back with everybody. Thank you very much. And doing the sound, did a wonderful job once again in the box up there, and he's done it for so many shows, was Warren. Give him another clap. Over many years, and the person who's put together more of them than anybody is Sue, so she needs a day. Such a wonderful support to all of us, and has been for so many years. The backdrop's amazing. She put so much time into it. But anything she needs done, she's helped me so many times and the children so many times, and she does it with so little fuss and with such good grace. So Nikki, thank you for so many years of helping these children.
Thank you.
the place.